the alarm can be operated with both an alarm remote, but more importantly with the fear key. So locking and unlocking the vehicle will arm and disarm automatically. So lock, you should get one beep. One beep for armed, and you can hear the doors clunk into action. Unlock. Two beeps. Unlocked. You can arm the alarm and isolate the internal sensors with the remote as well. So lock in the normal fashion, wait between 4 and 5 seconds, and a second press of the lock key gets a high-pitched beep and just confirms that the internal sensors have been disabled. In a similar way, the alarm remote will also trigger the locking and unlocking. So, arm will arm the alarm and lock the doors. Disarm will disarm and unlock the doors. Where the central locking works, the habitation door, it will also lock and unlock the habitation door. And this time, night mode or pet mode, if you like, can be triggered with a single press on the alarm remote. A button 3 that looks a little bit like a Wi-Fi button. That's it. One beep, armed, doors are locked, internal sensor isolated. Okay, just a quick video to show you how you can tell the source of your alarm trigger. So in this instance, you're going to approach the vehicle when the alarm has triggered and disarm the alarm. You get the telltale 5 beeps to tell you that the alarm's triggered in your absence. We're now going to go inside the van, put the ignition on and count the flashes from the little LED, and that will tell us what the source of the trigger was. Okay, so enter the vehicle. You simply turn the ignition on and the little LED will flash on a cycle to tell us the source of the trigger. So we'll count the flashes, 1, 2, 3, 4, pause, 1, 2, 3, 4, pause, and if we check our little handbook, 4 flashes, it's the bonnet switch. So we know in this instance the bonnet switch being tampered with has triggered the alarm. And one of the quite unique extra sensors that we can add to the Gemini alarm system is a wireless window sensor. Fits neatly on the window, and you have to move very fast. You know, the red light, that's the alarm triggering. So you've got probably 6 to 10 mil of movement on that window before I've not even had to release all the window catches. So even really, the minute somebody starts to tamper with this and try and force it, we're going to trigger that alarm straight away. They can be fitted on the roof lights as well. Okay, one of the additional sensors that we can add, if you feel a bit of extra security is required, and we would certainly recommend on the likes of garage doors, is our wireless sensor. Any tamper of the garage door triggers the alarm. There you can see the little wireless sensor.